Hello. In today's lecture, we are going to study about dental plaque, the definition of dental plaque, how the dental plaque formation takes place, the composition of plaque, different microbial complexes which are included in dental plaque. All these things we will study in today's lecture. So, first of all, let us start with dental plaque. Dental plaque is clinically defined as a structured, a resilient yellowish-gray substance that is adhered tenaciously, that adheres tenaciously to the dental intraoral hard surfaces, including removable and fixed prostheses. Now, before going into the detail of dental plaque, let us first know a bit about difference between materia alba, dental plaque and dental calculus, plaque and calculus. Now, materia alba is an irregular structure, while these two are regular structures. These are regular structures. Materia alba has a cheese-like, whitish appearance. Dental plaque is a yellowish grey substance, and it is yellowish or greyish in color. Dental plaque is yellowish or greyish in color. Materia alba is loosely attached with the tooth and it can be easily removed. Dental plaque and calculus are firmly attached with the tooth, and they require special instruments for removal. Also, this consists of bacteria, disintegrating food substances and some salivary proteins. While dental plaque consists of bacteria, glycoproteins, proteoglycans, and in this mineralized substances like calcium and phosphate are present. At the time of birth of a child, when the child is delivered, initially the oral cavity is completely sterile, means it does not contain any bacteria. But soon after birth, as soon as birth is given to a child, the first bacteria to develop into an oral cavity is facultative anaerobic bacteria. This is very important to remember, and the bacteria that is usually found is Streptococcus salivaris. Now, within two weeks, the microbiota in the oral cavity, it matures, and at the time of 1 year, after 1 year, approximately 10 raised to the power of 14 microorganisms can be seen into the oral cavity of the child. These points are very important regarding MCQs, so you must keep them in mind. Nearly 600 different species of bacteria are found in an individual, and at a single time in an individual, nearly 150 different species of bacteria can be seen in the oral cavity of an individual at one particular time. So these are the different points which you have to remember, that nearly 600 different types of bacteria have been identified in different individuals of the oral cavity, but in an individual at a single time it is 150. Now let us study something about ecological niche. What is an ecological niche? Ecological niche is also known as oral ecosystem. Now, what is an oral ecosystem? An ecosystem is an environment in which living and non-living things live in compatibility, means they live in a mutually beneficial relationship. Now, there are 5 different oral ecosystems into the oral cavity. 5 different oral ecosystems are present into the oral cavity. The first one is the supragingival plaque. Supragingival plaque. Intraoral hard structures like tooth, removable and fixed prosthesis. The second one is the periodontal and peri-implant pocket, means the pocket which is, or the sulcus which is present around the implant, pocket or sulcus. The third one is the epithelium of buccal mucosa, palate and floor of the mouth. The fourth one is the dorsum of the tongue, and the fifth one is the tonsil. Now, out of all these 5 ecosystems, this intraoral hard structures like the tooth and the removable and the fixed prosthesis are non-renewable, means the epithelium is not denuded, they are the constant structures. So plaque can form over all these structures. So the next point is, teeth and implants are stable stages. These provide stable structures in the oral cavity over which plaque is found. While the epithelium of the cheek, the palate and the floor of the mouth keeps on turning over, means floor of the mouth have a high turnover rate, so plaque cannot develop over these surfaces. Now, the bacteria like AA and P. gingivalis, bacterial count will decrease near to null after full mouth extraction or till the period of newborn when first tooth erupts. Means AA and P. gingivalis are the bacteria which are found only on the hard structures like the tooth. Whenever there is full mouth extraction done, no AA or P. gingivalis can be detected into the oral cavity. Similarly, until the first tooth erupts into the oral cavity of the child, no AA or P. gingivalis can be determined into the oral cavity. Now, let us see what are obligate periphytes. Periphytes are the microorganisms which develop into the periodontium. So, obligate periphytes are the categories of bacterias which are present in the oral cavity at all time, and these bacterias are mostly they belong to the Streptococcus group. Most common example is Streptococcus mutans. So Streptococcus mutans is an obligate periphyte which is mostly found into the oral cavity, whether in a young child or an adult, whether in patient with periodontitis or without periodontitis. Now, some of the very important facts which you have to remember in NCQs are, a plaque contains 2 into 10 raised to the power of 11 bacteria. The amount of bacteria in plaque that is found is 2 into 10 raised to the power of 11 bacteria. And the amount of bacteria found, if the question is 1 gram plaque in wet weight, the wet weight of 1 gram of plaque contains how much of bacteria, then the answer will be 10 raised to the power of 11 bacteria. Now, supragingival plaque. The supragingival plaque, the plaque that is above the marginal gingiva, contains 10 raised to the power of 11 bacteria, and the subgingival plaque or the periodontal pocket of a healthy individual contains 10 raised to the power of 3 bacteria. And a diseased conditions, means in periodontitis, the amount of bacteria present are 10 raised to the power of 8. Now, let us discuss about the 3 types of gingival plaque, 3 types of dental plaque. The plaque can be divided into, based on its location, into 3 types, which are supragingival, marginal plaque and subgingival plaque. Now, supragingival is the plaque that is present above the gingival margin. The plaque that is present at the level of the gingival margin is known as the marginal plaque, and the plaque that is present below the gingival margin or into the sulcus or periodontal pocket is known as subgingival plaque. Now, let us see the different microorganisms present in this plaque. First, let us see the supragingival plaque. Suppose this is the tooth and this is the pocket. So, supragingival plaque is present in this region. Now, the plaque that is in direct contact with the tooth surface, this is mainly consists of gram-positive cocci and rods. It consists of gram-positive rods and cocci. Now, the plaque which is present, the plaque that is present here over this is mainly consisting of gram-negative rods and cocci, gram-negative rods and cocci, and apart from this, filamentous organisms can also be seen. Filamentous organisms can also be seen in this part of the plaque. Now, let us see, the marginal gingival plaque has a concentration similar to supragingival plaque. Now, let us go to the subgingival plaque. The subgingival plaque is divided in into three parts: tooth associated plaque, tissue associated plaque, and the unattached plaque. So, the tissue associated in the subgingival plaque, subgingival plaque is divided into three types: tooth associated, tissue associated, and free or unattached plaque. Unattached plaque in between these two. Now, the plaque associated with tooth has large number of gram negative rods and cocci and filamentous rods are present in tooth associated plaque. Apart from this, the apical portion of this tooth associated plaque is separated from junctional epithelium. The apical portion is separated from junctional epithelium by leukocytes. This is a very important point which you all must remember, that the apical portion of tooth associated plaque is separated by a layer of leukocytes from the junctional epithelium. Now, in the tissue associated plaque, the main organisms which are found are gram negative rods, filaments. Apart from these two organisms, spirochetes and other motile organisms are also present. Motile organisms are also present in tissue associated plaque, which can be seen later on into the pocket and into the connective tissue of the gingiva. So, you have to remember these all points for MCQs. Now, let us see, there can be two surfaces of dental plaque, towards the tissue and outer surface, which we have already seen. The tooth surface consists more of gram-positive cocci and short rods, and the outer surface consists of gram-negative rods, filaments and the spirochetes, which is mostly present into the mature plaque. As we have already seen, that the apical extent of gingival plaque is separated from the underlining junctional epithelium from host leukocytes and bacteria, which are mostly gram-negative rods. This point is an important point which you have to remember. Now, let us see plaque as a biofilm. What is a biofilm? A biofilm is an environment in which biofilm consists of a complex interaction of bacteria and tooth surface plus extracellular matrix of the plaque. Now, suppose this is the structure of diagrammatically how we can represent biofilm. This is the biofilm. Now biofilm has various nutrient channels or fluid channels. This constitutes the circulatory system of the plaque biofilm, through which these are the nutrient channels, through which exchange of nourishment to the bacteria and the fluids occurs through these nutrient channels. They are present throughout the plaque biofilm. Apart from this, the plaque biofilm consists of extracellular matrix, which forms the backbone of the biofilm. In this biofilm, what are the major ingredients? The major component of this biofilm are the different types of microorganisms. Microorganisms which are present in the plaque biofilm. How these microorganisms are retained into the plaque? These are retained with help of various organic and inorganic substances. These might be the organic substances like glycoproteins, organic substances like lipids, glycoproteins, proteoglycans, polysaccharides. These are the substances which are responsible for adherence of plaque bacteria into the biofilm. Thus, this is the interaction, how these bacteria interact with each other and apart from this, various inorganic constituents like inorganic constituents such as sodium, phosphate, calcium, potassium are also present in the plaque biofilm, which are responsible for the interaction with the bacteria. So this is the complex structure, which is little bit simplified in this diagram of the biofilm. Thus we can say that plaque is a type of biofilm and has its own complex ecological niche. The plaque has a circulatory system, which we have already discussed. This is the circulatory system of the plaque, and molecular diffusion of the nutrients occurs through these open fluid filled water channels. Also, the plaque the saliva in the mouth consists of various planktonic bacteria. What are planktonic bacteria? Planktonic bacteria are the free floating bacteria which are present in the saliva and GCF. And there are certain bacteria which are adhered to the surfaces. So these free floating bacteria come in contact with the salivary pellicle and the bacteria in the biofilm, and thus they attract each other and form a part of the plaque biofilm. Let us see the composition of plaque. Plaque consists of two basic ingredients, the organic and the inorganic part. The organic part of the plaque consists of primarily polysaccharides. The most important polysaccharide which is present in the plaque is dextran. Dextran constitutes round about 95% of the dental plaque biofilm. And levans are, apart from dextran, levans are also present, which constitute the remaining 5% of plaque biofilm. Also, extracellular polysaccharides. These extracellular polysaccharides helps the bacteria to adhere to the tooth surface. As we have previously seen, plaque biofilm consists of extracellular polysaccharides, and these extracellular polysaccharides constitutes the backbone of plaque biofilm, in which various interactions amongst bacteria, organic and inorganic constituents take place. Now, apart from these polysaccharides, plaque also consists of glycoprotein, lipids. This lipid is derived from the host membrane of the host cells in the bacteria, and proteins. The most important protein which is present in the plaque is the albumin. Now, the inorganic content of plaque consists of primarily calcium. Apart from calcium, it consists of phosphorus, and in minor quantity it consists of sodium, potassium and fluoride from the saliva. let us discuss few questions regarding this topic. The first question is, dental plaque adheres with the tooth surface because the option number one is levans are gummy. Now, as we all know, levans constitute only 5% composition of pellicle. So, this cannot be the answer. The second option is dextrans. Dextrans constitute 95% extracellular matrix of the plaque, definitely, and it is insoluble and sticky. This is the dextran which is responsible for the formation of extracellular matrix of the plaque biofilm. Thus, we can say that this can be the answer. The third option is plaque grows in the irregularities. This option we can rule out because plaque does not grow into the irregularities of the tooth. The plaque attaches, the plaque is formed with the biofilm, and in the biofilm there are various microorganisms which attach to the pellicle. So this answer, plaque does not grow into the irregularities of the tooth. It is the dental calculus which develops into the, grows into the irregularities of the tooth over the plaque. So this option is also ruled out. The next option is microorganisms produce sticky lipoproteins. As we all know, none of the microorganisms produce sticky lipoproteins. Microorganisms attach to the dental pellicle with the help of receptors and certain molecules present in them. They do not produce any sticky lipoproteins. They have lipopolysaccharides but no lipoproteins. So the answer to this question is number second. Dextrans are insoluble and sticky. This is a direct question. The question is, salivary pellicle is composed of the following except. You have to remember, salivary pellicle is composed of all of the following except. Now, as we have already discussed, salivary pellicle consists of immunoglobulin G, it consists of amylase, and it consists of immunoglobulin A as well. So, what the option which we are left with is albumin. So, the answer to this question is second, albumin. Salivary pellicle is composed of all of the following except albumin.